Hello students, today we are going to learn systematic listening, counting and reasoning. Shall we start? Children, what is counting? Do we really need it? Does it help us? Yes, it does help us in our everyday life. Teacher counts students to see how many students are present in the class. And on your birthday, you count the chocolates to distribute among your friends, right? And if the chocolates are less and your friends are more, then you ask your mother to buy more, isn't it? So counting helps us a lot. It helps us and everyone, teacher, mother, father, grandma, grandpa, shopkeepers and everyone to solve everyday problem. Let's try to make these numbers more interesting. Now, all of you, please close your eyes and start imagining any figure, drawing, which can be formed using number 1 or 2 or 3. Can you imagine number 1 or digit 1 in the chalk which a teacher uses? Okay, now open your eyes. Can you see a duck or a swan can be drawn using number 2, a rabbit using number 3, a koala bear using number 19, and a shark with number 22. Wow, the numbers are hidden inside these pictures. Isn't it interesting? So in this class, we are going to learn what is counting, how numbers are used to count and list the objects, how counting helps us to solve our problems in daily lives. Children, please observe the numbers which are displayed on the slide carefully and see the numbers are of different size, shape and color. I know your birthday must be your favorite number, isn't it? Now see on the screen the numbers which are displayed on the screen. Which is the smallest number? 2, right? But if you observe carefully, the size of number 2 is the biggest. But does this big size make 2 the biggest number? No. So, what do we understand? The size of the number is not important to find out which number is biggest or smallest. But its value is important. And thus, even if 2 is biggest in size, its value is smallest among the remaining 2 numbers. Now tell me which is the largest number from these 3 numbers? 5, right? Because the value of 5 is greater than 2 and 3, even if the size is small. Children, you all must be having your favorite color, isn't it? Now just look at the slide. There are many colors. Can you count now how many colors are displayed in the slide? 7, right? Red, orange, blue, purple, green, dark gray and light gray. Can you find out how many numbers are there on the slide? Is the number of colors and digits are equal? No. Red color is displayed twice and also orange color, isn't it? So the number of numbers or digits are less than the number of colors. So children, why do we need numbers? To identify how much. When you are sick and you go to the doctor, doctor asks you to take 1 or 2 spoons of medicine, 1 or 2 tablets. So numbers help us to identify how much of a quantity is needed. Secondly, the numbers are important to relate it to the quantity. If every student has to be given 1 seat in the class to sit, each one gets 1 seat only. No student will be given 2 seats to sit. So we are relating the number with the quantity. Also, the numbers have fixed sequence or order. 1 comes before 2 and 3 comes after 2. If you are standing in the queue for a pizza, you don't get it unless the people who are standing before you get their pizza. And the one who is standing after you will not get the pizza before you. Do you know mathematics is required everywhere? Can you tell me why do you think? Okay, let us find out through a story from Panchatantra, where the stork instructs the tortoise to hold on the stick and not to speak until they land. As they were flying, people on the ground see the tortoise flying by holding a stick. They start laughing and pointing to the tortoise. When the tortoise hears people shouting, he gets excited and without thinking what would happen, he speaks. And then what happens? He falls down. Poor tortoise. He should have thought before speaking, right? So this is why we should think. And mathematics can help us think and sharpen our thinking skills. Can you see black and grey dots here? How many black dots are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Now tell me, how many grey dots are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Children, doesn't your teacher tells you to stand in a straight line when you go anywhere? See how when these dots are in a line, it becomes so easy to count them. This is called a list or sequence of dots. See the dots. It's so difficult to count black and grey dots in the left side figure because they are not in line. And on the right side, the dots are in line, so it's easy to count. Now observe carefully. How many colors do you see? Red, green, blue and yellow. 4, right? How many squares have black dots inside it? 2, yellow and blue. And how many squares do not have dots? Again 2, right? What are they? Red and green. Children, you must have observed, after taking attendance, many times your teacher count the number of children just to check whether she has written the attendance correctly and how many students are present. If in the class the number of children and number of seats are equal, then just by counting the empty seats, teacher can find how many children are absent. Now, you find on your own how many children are there in the class today and how many total seats are there in your class. Okay, now we'll do one activity. Everyone sit on your desks. No one will get up. The teacher will now pass duster to the student which is nearest to her. Each student must take the duster, then give it to the next student. Keep passing it on until all the students get to touch the duster. Let the last student who touched the duster keep it for now. Did everyone get to touch the duster? How many children touched it just once? And more than once? Good. Now, ask the last student to return the duster to the teacher. Not all students need to touch it. Ask them to pass it back as quickly as possible by using only a few students. How many students touched the duster while returning it to the teacher? Good. Children, you have to tell me now, how many children have the same name in your class? If not in your class, in your school there will be many children having the same name. Still, your teacher can find out the unique child. How? with the surname, isn't it? In your break time, count children with same name and starting with alphabet A and alphabet S, and then compare where children with names starting with alphabet A or S are more. Will you do this? Good. What is the first alphabet of your name? Say it aloud. Okay. Now all students whose name begins with A, raise your hands. Let us count how many students have first name starting with alphabet A. Which student's name begin with alphabet S? Say your name out loud. All students whose name begins with S, raise your hands. Good. Let us count how many students have first name starting with alphabet S. Good. Now, we have both numbers, number of students with first name starting with A and those starting with S. You can now find which one is greater. So, mathematics is required in daily lives. To share pizza equally, to share seats in the class so that everyone gets to sit. In a movie theater, everyone with a ticket gets to sit. To read time on a watch or clock or mobile phone to see whether we are late or in time. To know what comes before, after, or in between. So, dear students, what did we learn today? Numbers, counting, why do we need numbers and counting, and examples in day-to-day life. Thank you. See you soon.